Hi guys, this is Sunit here once again. I'm the founder and CEO of BeForest. Today I'll be talking to someone who's closely associated with all of our collectives, Biome Environment Solutions, the directors of the company, Anurag and Sharad, in conversation with us talking about how we think of landscapes and how architecture plays a great role in designing the landscape as well as the structures on it. Sharad and Anurag, welcome.
Thank you, Sunit.
Guys, the first thing I want to start off with is the name of the company itself, Biome. It literally means the entire ecosystem put together. Now, keeping that in mind, when you think of a landscape, when you look at a site for the first time, I'd like to walk us through the design process to start off with. Like, what are the things you look out for? Any key thumb rules you try to follow?
So, when we look at a landscape or even a project, even if it's a building project, we try and understand it or look at that space as a unit of ecology that, or a biome, right? So when we look at land or when we say landscape, it goes beyond the general notion of landscape, which is, you know, plants, or that's horticulture really.
Right.
So we try and understand it, a given piece of land holistically. We also acknowledge that we share this piece of land with other living beings, whether it's plants, animals. We try and understand it in terms of resources that it has, soil, water.
Mm-hmm.
So an approach to a project is given by or is started by certain studies with this. Certain things we do given our training or the background knowledge or the experience we've gathered from older projects, which is like understanding land slopes, being able to select slopes which are appropriate for building and which are not appropriate for building. We understand hydrology of a land. Hydrology is how water flows on this particular land.
And you're talking about just how water flows on the surface, or are you looking below the surface also?
So both. So when we go below the surface, it's called hydrogeology. But when we look at surface, we're looking at hydrology. So by understanding both, we work at setting up buffer zones in the land, or let's say zones of conservation.
Mm-hmm.
Right. So once we understand the major flows of water, we define riparian zones around these places. So these would be zones of restricted or lesser activities. Whereas a hydrogeological study gives you an idea of what you don't see by the eye, right? What's happening below you. And this is very important in projects which are away from the city. They need a lot of water, and even industrial projects for that matter, right? So electricity is easy to draw. You just draw a wire, you go through that process, you invest and you get your electricity. Building is easier, but water, you will be more often than not dependent on groundwater. So it's important to put in conservation measures right in the early stages of the project. So a hydrogeological study tells you what parts of the site should you be holding water, allowing it to recharge, and from where should you be withdrawing it. So that becomes an input in your land use plan.
So when you say, are there particular, is it like an instrument that actually studies the ground below, or is it some indicators that you look for?
It would be a combination of both. Okay. There would be indicators, there would be experience that these people would have. So again, what happens is, when you're working on such a large piece of land, you have to work with other domain experts. So it's a hydrogeologist in Pumale, which we are working with you.
Right.
There are wildlife experts. Some other places, it would be a horticulturist.
Given that the farming is also a focus, it's not only the built spaces what we're looking for. So to identify the land which is more fertile and to have that kind of a negotiation where the land which is appropriate for buildings, you find that out and allocate the land which is more productive, where you have better soil moisture in it, look at the humus content in it. So identifying these locations, not also, or citing not only from the building perspective, but looking at your other usages of that area. And the new thing what we are looking at now along with water is also to how to conserve the soil and the land, because in these slope terrains, it's very easy to lose your soil if you don't have a ground cover or if you don't have trees. Yeah.